Hey, what's up guys, it's Number One Bread here, and today what I'll be bringing you guys is another class setup video. Today what I'll be reviewing for you guys today is the Atlas 20mm Sniper, and in my opinion this is the best sniper in its category, otherwise I wouldn't be showing you this weapon in its class loadout. So for all you snipers out there, you're in for a treat, here's the sniper class setup for you. Now, I'm going to start off with obviously the gun. The Atlas 20mm is actually the strongest gun in its category. It deals the most damage. It is a one-shot kill anywhere from the head to the feet and the hands. So the only place it's not a one-shot kill is at the feet and the hands, which means it's a very, very strong sniper. And you must literally be pinpointly bad if you hit the hand or the foot. This sniper rifle is a little different to the other snipers in its category. The reason for that is because this one is a shoulder mounted sniper, which means it rests on your shoulder a little bit like a bazooka, and it does have that sort of bazooka feel when you're holding it. It does look like a stinger or whatnot when you do hold it. This makes it, you know, more powerful, and it balances it out a bit more because snipers are supposed to be heavy weapons, and because it's shoulder mounted, it doesn't allow you to hip fire with it, which is something that does benefit a lot of people when you're sniping, because snipers are supposed to be aimed in and not sprayed without aiming in. That's pretty much the sniper logic. You're supposed to aim in, shoot people at long ranges, that's how snipers work. So this complements the sniper even more because you don't get those lucky no scopes, and it makes you want to use the sniper how it's supposed to be. The two attachments that I do stick on the weapon are the extended mags and this ballistic CPU. The extended mags obviously gives you more ammo in the clip, and ballistic CPU is also helpful, so it reduces the sniper sway, so it allows you to get that shot off and most likely hit the target. Next I go on to the secondary, which is a PDW pistol. This pistol is a fully automatic pistol, and any secondary can be useful because pistols obviously have high mobility, and that can compensate for your sniper being a long range weapon and not very good at short range, especially when this weapon is not good for short range because it's unable to hip fire. So you're going to need to switch out that pistol quickly and kill the enemies that are close to you before they get to you. Now moving on to the perks. For a wild card I have chosen Perk 1 Greed, which allows me to have two perks in my Perk 1 tier slot. Those two perks are Low Profile and Lightweight. Low Profile allows me to be concealed from the enemy UAV and remain stationary, feeling safe and the fact that they won't come and find me as easily. Lightweight as well is useful because it allows you to increase your mobility with a sniper, because snipers obviously aren't the most mobile weapons. For perk 2 I've selected Fast Hands. Fast Hands allows me to pull out my secondary as fast as possible if an enemy does get close to me and does obviously find out my position, allowing me to switch my pistol and being able to take them out with little cost of injury. For the third perk tier I've chosen Perk 3 Greed as one of my wild cards also. For the two perks on my Perk 3 tier I have Toughness and Scavenger. Toughness is really, really useful on a sniper because as you're zoomed in and you're getting shot at, your gun does tend to flinch a bit more since you are zoomed in, and toughness obviously reduces that so you're able to stay on your target whilst being shot at. Scavenger allows you to be fully ammunized at the start of each life, which means you can stay stationary as a sniper and not have to worry about running over dead bodies to pick up ammo. Of course, if the enemy does get close, you can whip out your pistol, kill them, and then run over their body for an extra mag, which is always useful. The exo ability I've chosen for this class is exo cloaking. The reason for that is because if an enemy does find out where you are or around your position on the minimap, because obviously if you shoot a sniper without a silencer on, you will come up on the minimap. So if an enemy does decide to come and track you down, or if a horde of enemies are on your way or in your position, then you can obviously call in the exo cloak, be invisible for a temporal amount of time, and be able to evade that trouble. And for the last slot of my class setup, I've chosen my one and only score streak, which is the UAV. The UAV allows me to reveal enemy position on the minimap. It gives me a clear idea of whereabouts they are and whether I should be prepared for inbound attack or not. For the UAV I've given it two upgrades. I've given it the speed upgrade, which allows it to sweep faster so I can get an even more accurate position on where the enemies are, and also I've given it an upgrade of direction. That means I know where the enemies are facing and therefore can pinpoint where they are. That's it for today's class setup on the Sniper. Hopefully you guys did enjoy today's class setup video. Hopefully it did benefit you and you can learn from this and hopefully do well in your games. If you did enjoy it or found this class setup useful, make sure to hit that like rating down below. And also to subscribe if you haven't already, because there'll be some insane Call of Duty content coming your way. Also, make sure to check all the links down in the description down below. Hopefully you guys did enjoy this video once again. Have an awesome day, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.